Welcome to Clouds Training. This is part 2 of OOPS Concepts training program. In this lesson, we will learn properties and fields. Though it is a small topic, it is very important to know the concept of properties and fields. These properties and fields represents the information that a particular object holds. Let us understand how we can create these properties and fields in action. Here I have opened the previous solution that we have created in classes and structures lesson. Let us add a new project to this solution. And it will be a console application. Console application Visual C Sharp. Let's name it as Properties and Fields. If you notice, we are following the same naming convention as per the topic that we are discussing. I have paused the video and copied the class that we have created in our previous lesson from here. In our previous lesson, we have created an integer property called ID with get and set methods. These will internally set the value and read the value that we assign to this property. When we run this application, before running, you need to select this as a startup project and click on start. We can see that the value of ID is printed as 1. Hit enter to close. This is where the value of ID is printed. Now let's remove this get and set from here. Let's create this as a simple field and run the application again. We will see the same output. That means it clearly indicates that behind the scenes, this property is initializing the get and set methods to assign and read the values from this property. The same behavior can be achieved with a more traditional way of defining the property using the private variable. We will assign the public property with getters and setters. In this way, we have more granular control on what is being assigned to this property and what is being read from this property. We can do manipulations, we can add conditions on these properties. If we assign a value to this name property and print to the console, we can see the results by running the console application. Here we can see the name is printed as Alex. In this scenario, both these properties, in this case, both the ID and name exhibit the same behavior when it comes to read and write operations. We are able to read the value and assign the value. However, if we comment this set action, we can see that object.name assignment is no longer valid. Name property becomes read-only and we no longer be able to assign the value to it. Let's comment this out. We can assign this value in our class to a private member and run the application, we can see that Alex is printed here. The easiest way to auto-generate these properties in Visual Studio is type prop prop and hit tab. It will automatically generate property for you with get and set. If you want to generate properties with private variable and if you want more control over it, you can type prop full, hit tab, and then you can update these values. This is how simple it is to create properties and fields in a class. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.